to calculate electric field, the Gauss's law is easiest way for a charge distribution. For point charge distribution, we can easily find the electric field using Coulomb's law. But for a continuous charge distribution, let this is sphere of continuous charge distribution, means the charge Q is spread all over the volume, then the electric field for this type of system or this type of charge distribution can be easily calculated using Gauss's law. So there should be let we are going to find the electric field due to a uniformly charged sphere. Let us sphere of radius r and charge q and the charge density, volume charge density rho, that is rho means total charge by total volume, is given. We have to find out the electric field at various point. First point should be maybe in outside the sphere, so this is our case one. If the point of measurement, that is, suppose this is r, placed in outside the sphere, that is small r greater than capital R, for this case we have to just take imaginary Gaussian sphere or Gaussian surface using the sphere of radius small r. So our Gaussian surface is four pi r square. So for this case the total flux phi e equals to integration of e dot ds equals to q enclosed or q in by epsilon 0 from Gauss's law. As e is depend on r, so e can take constant, and e dot ds gives e ds cos 0, because e and ds has a same direction normal to the surface. That is, we can take e integration of surface integration of ds equals to q by epsilon, in this case q in means q, so e equals e 4 pi r square equals to q by epsilon naught, that is e equals to q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square. So this is the electric field in scale magnitude, and in vector there should be a direction of r cap, because electric field direction is outer to the surface and normal to the surface. So this will be case 2. If r less than r, that is, if the surface is in between the sphere, so for this case equation should be same, that is phi e or u e dot ds equals to q in by epsilon naught. Here q in equals to not q, because q in is that in between area, that is sorry, in between volume, that is 4 third pi r cube into rho. Rho is the volume charge density, that is charge per volume by epsilon naught. This implies further integration. Therefore, like previous case, this is 4 pi r square equals to 4 pi r cube rho by 3 epsilon naught. This implies e equals to r rho by 3 epsilon naught. So in first case, e proportional to 1 by r square in second case E proportional to R, and there should be third case, case 3, that is on the surface, means small r equals to capital R. So just put small r as capital R in, or replace small r with capital R in the case 1, that is E equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught capital R square r unit. So this is our third case. We can plot also the electric field versus radius or distance. So let this is the capital R, means the diameter, radius of the sphere. So in between the sphere R, E proportional to R, so just like a straight line, and after that this equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught capital R square, then E proportional to 1 by R square, so just like decreasing this, there should be symmetrically in this case. So this is the direction of E and this is the direction of R.